Verizon is a research partner of the Center for Threat Informed Defense. What is it that Verizon's looking to get out of that the relationship?
The DBIR is a public good publication, right? It's a really bleak landscape out there. It's really hard to know what you should be doing, right? And then we believe it's our responsibility to provide folks with the best tooling that they potentially get, right? And I think that aligns just very cleanly with the overall high-level mission of the center, right?
So people love to talk about the you know, since the 1700s, the tragedy of the commons. But I heard you coin a great term recently.
I had offered that what we're doing here in the center is the opposite of the tragedy of the commons. And I think we ended up in the prosperity of the commons as the tagline, right? Someone has to build the plumbing. Someone has to build the infrastructure, right? You can't just keep pointing around and expecting the other person to do so. We will build the highways, right? So that a lot of great economic activity can happen on top of them, right? But someone has to come and say, okay, I'm going to do it.
Verizon's participated in 8 projects, some of which have completed and have been published, some which are underway. Wondering if you would sort of talk about sort of some of the range of projects.
So one of the more practical ones that we worked on, which I'm very proud of the outcome and the way that the team was very actively a part of it, is the cloud stack mappings for Azure. A couple of bets we have placed with you folks recently have to do with the Attack Workbench project, which is enabling folks to have their own localized version extension of Attack without a lot of hassle. I think the core project for us this year was really the work we did together on the Attack to Verisk mapping. We've always been very interested in empowering folks. I mean, the work is very difficult, right? It's a big challenge. And to be able to empower folks to give things their proper names so they can guide themselves, having a framework to understand what could potentially be affecting you, right? And understand that, well, if I'm being hit a lot by this specific thing, maybe this is one avenue, this is one place where I should be focusing my control efforts, right? And this is something that Verisk proposes to do on a very high strategic level, right? And it's something that Attack has been very successful in on the more technological aspects. It becomes a very powerful translation layer, in my opinion, right? Where you can way easier than before. I'm not claiming this to be easy in any moment in time, but way easier than before. You can flip the coin from the technical to the strategic.
What is it that you think are the areas that either you're excited to try to tackle the new areas, or maybe just more focus on existing areas?
There needs to be a way to describe what we do. There needs to be a language. There needs to be a model. There needs to be some sort of connective glue where we can again describe the building blocks of, this is the type of attack, or this is the type of defense you should have, right? So I see what we're collectively building, right? With all the mappings, right? With joining standards together, mapping attack to specific controls, we're really creating a taxonomy. We're really creating some sort of like skeleton where we can, in a better way, understand what we do. So then we can get to measuring what we do, and maybe someday optimizing what we do. It was never as clear to me as it has been working with the center on how much within reach that is.